What's up, everybody? Jackson here, and today I want to read an article that I have to give the award for the absolute dumbest fucking story I've ever found while just Googling randomly fucking video game news. This is not video game news. So Google, you fucking failed me. Not for the first time, not for the last time, but I'm still gonna forgive you and I'm still gonna use you incessantly, but fuck you still. This is not video game news. This is written by a man named Simon Parkin for The Guardian. I've had several commenters tell me, like, I did a video on these fucking dumb women who did the fucking top sex. They do, like, sex stories involving video games for The fucking Guardian, and they're dumb. They are the absolute dumbest dumb. It's as if you gave two filthy whores the subject of writing about it. Like, they're not video game girls that are filthy whores. They're filthy whores that are talking about video games. And so I did a story on that. I had several commenters telling me, The Guardian, like, I didn't know what the fuck this was. I was shielded. But apparently it was a publication, and now it's an online thing. And you know what's cute is at the end of every single one of these articles, I'll have links to several other useless fucking articles by Mr. Simon Parkin. Simon Parkin! I am a unique video game critic! This fucking guy. So he writes this article, I find it. It says, "The unique shame of the video game critic." I had to read it. Am I not gonna read that? Come on, you fucking guys know me. Am I not gonna read a fucking article that starts out, "The unique shame of the video game critic"? This is with real lives and real rights under threat. What's the point of writing about virtual worlds? That is the article header. With real lives and real rights under threat. What's the point of writing about virtual worlds? Oh my god, you poor little baby. You poor, poor little baby. Let's start reading this. Early into the video game critic's career, the statement, "I write about video games for a living," assumes the fraught, almost tearful character of a confession. You know, I had grand plans, you know, but I ended up writing for video games for a living. I'm so fucking sad. Even in its highest form, something like the sifting of art and entertainment in search of truth or beauty. Oh my god. The critic's profession is something of a superfluity for the species. Marooned on a desert island, the critic can only whisper "fair cop" when his co-survivors reveal the result of their vote on whom to eat first. Oh, but fair cop. I write about video games for a living. You can eat my thigh bone first and just pick apart the marrow. It'll keep you alive. Just please remember that I had grand plans, but I write for video games for a living on this marooned island in the desert of nowhere. Criticism is not a practical skill. It saves no lives. What if you go, "Hey, how about instead of eating that motherfucker, we go look over in them trees and maybe we find some coconuts. Some coconuts." Critique is very useful, you idiot. Critique is the reason we have evolved as a species to where we are now. Because the people in power in, like, the Dark Ages, do you think they wanted shit to change? Shit was splendid for them, right? They could go out and fuck brides before their wedding, you know, shit like that. You think they want anything to change, you stupid fucking whiny bitch? No. Critics changed it. Who do you think the founding fathers were? Who do you think all the great revolutionaries in fucking history were? They were all critics. You are a fucking asinine moron. I can't even believe you exist. I'm definitely gonna support your fucking publication. Dude.
Self-doubt is the common cold of writerly ailments, doubly so for the critic of an emergent form. At its worst, criticism is the blunt tool of the professionally envious, a youthful corruption of power, as Martin Amis put it. Even Auden admitted that the critic, by definition, must be a bit of a show-off. Notice that I'm name-dropping. The philosopher Franken Banco here went further. Francis Bacon went further. Critics are, he wrote in 1652, quoting Henry Wharton, another name drop. Look at how smart I am. I write about video games for a living. Brushes of nobleman's clothes. But to pick video games for one subject, this is to enter new realms of childish indulgence. The former Guardian columnist Charlie Brooker, who cut his teeth writing for a video game magazine, once wrote that saying you write about video games for a living is a bit like admitting you review Mr. Men books professionally. It invites the bewildered follow-up. So where did it all go wrong? Just eat my leg. Go ahead. I'm useless. It is not a practical skill. Defending video games as a worthwhile subject during the medium's emergence decades has been tough. The blockbusters are often flimsy carnivals of pyrotechnics studded with DOA dialogue. Perversely, they make great demands on the critic, who must frantically draw meaning and interest from what little is there. When an authentically interesting game comes along, the temptation for the honest critic is to overpraise and trip into advocacy of the medium. Its own kind of well-meaning dishonesty. But no matter how scintillating the text, when the real world starts to tremble, when fascism begins to rise, when the bombs start to fall, when real lives and real rights are imperiled, the job of writing about virtual worlds is just further undercut. Why waste our time focused on fictional quests when so much of the real world is in need of repair? You are in the wrong profession, okay? If you have to ask that question, you're fucking your life up, man. Why? Because videos are the ultimate unifier, motherfucker. Video games are the thing that will bring us together. When I'm fucking playing a game and I've got a good team going, you know what? I could give a fuck less what my team feels about religion, race, whatever. I could give a fuck less. As long as we're doing it the right way. We're working as a team towards the better goal of victory. Alright? And that teaches us something that our species lacks and has lacked for a long time. Unification. Video games are about unification. You fucking asinine. Dude, this guy's fucking... He's just like, they're definitely gonna eat someone. Right? If you get stuck on a desert island, like, you guys are definitely gonna eat someone, right? Like, that's just... This guy has a shit view on humanity. He's got a shit view on video games. And he's got a shit view on everything. And I can't imagine what it would be like to spend one day in this miserable person's fucking dome. I bet it would suck. This fucking guy. I don't care. I'm not gonna finish it. He finally mentions video games down here, but he mentions The Papers, Please as an extraordinary study of nationalism, immigration, and the way in which compassion can so often become strangled by red tape. In peacetime, it's a cautionary tale. This month, it feels like a superfluous mirror. We already know how ugly we are. Who are you talking about? We already know how ugly we are. Who the fuck are you talking about? We. Who? Anyway, at the bottom of this, and every article written by him that I can see, since you're here, we have a small favor to ask. More people are reading The Guardian than ever, but far fewer are paying for it. Why would anyone pay for this shit? I'm reading this as a gag, man. I saw your header and it made me fucking laugh. And then I came over here and this article just made me laugh further. You are a joke of a paper. You are a joke of a publication. Okay? This is something you need to understand. Is the reason no one gives a shit about what you're writing about video games is no one who plays video games is taking this shit serious. Right? So no one playing video games who takes this shit serious is giving you any money because you're not taking it serious, motherfucker. So why the fuck should we take you serious? You're writing about fucking the just a random fucking, you know, just to be existential for existential sake. You know, trying to be a deep thinker. Just write about video games, dude. Be happy with your fucking lot in life. There's a lot of us who would love to be getting paid money to write professionally about video games. All right? We would die for that chance. We would fucking, you know, we would love that chance. But here you are crying and bitching about it. And you expect us, the people who are supposed to take you serious, who are supposed to give a fuck about what you say, Mr. Sammy Pearson, you expect us to take you serious when you don't even take the shit that we love serious. You view it as a fucking pointless, this is a pointless pursuit. Bombs are dropping in real life. Fascism is spreading. It's like, dude, we need awareness on that, sure. But you don't need to be the one to fucking do it. Alright? That's the problem with the video game fucking... This is the problem with the media and the video games. They think all of this shit needs to be in video games. It doesn't need to be in video games. They try to write us all out as racist, sexist, chauvinistic motherfuckers who treat people all like shit. We're just satisfying murder itch. It's not like that, man. We're not like that. If you met me in real life, you would not even know that I was the same dude from the rant videos. Because I, in real life, I'm very respectful. I listen to other people, you know. I will listen to your opinion. And I will be respectful to your opinion and the argument as long as you continue to do the same with me. All right? But that's the thing. This whole fucking way that they've painted us only serves their purpose further. It lets them get in deeper and deeper and deeper until there's like, it's just everywhere. Right? And they're saying we're all hateful, we're all just fucking disgusting, hateful pieces of shit, and blah, blah, blah. Well, really, we're just some dudes who like to fucking, the competitive edge, maybe, the fucking peaceful edge, maybe. You know, there's games that fucking make me think more. Open me up spiritually. Fucking Mass Effect, man. I'm not even gonna tell you how fucking, that game fucking changed my fucking life at a time when I needed something to change. Alright? So this is the thing, but that's all superfluous. It's unimportant. It's pointless. Or no, the superfluous was the mirror. We're staring in a superfluous mirror because we all know how ugly we are. You don't speak for me. I don't think you speak for my audience. I don't think you speak for gamers. And I think that's why you're having to beg for fucking spare change at the end of every single one of your fucking articles, motherfucker. And I think that's why you're writing shit like this, name dropping 18 fucking, like, Jesus Christ, man. You know? I felt that dick hit me across the face after the third or fourth fucking name you fucking had to throw out there to see, show that you were smart. Jesus. Anyway. It's pathetic. It made me laugh. I promise you guys, if we were stuck on a desert island, we'd find some coconuts. We'd find some coconuts. We wouldn't have to eat nobody. No one would have to die, not on my watch. I love you guys. Take care. Till next time, keep being awesome. Stay safe. Love ya.